gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome. I welcome you to Fiery Salient. We have the Roush. Roush is in the T-37. In the last couple of days, I have unlocked the T-49, and it is shit tons of fun. Unbelievable amounts of fun. This is the encounter mode. And my cat is meowing in the background because she desperately wants attention, even though I'm already petting her, so she wants even more attention than that. Crazy bested cat. T-37 is pretty much the Chaffee. I don't know why they even bothered changing the name. They should have just called this one the Chaffee and left it alone. You have been spoodled. And almost crashing into the M4. That would be unfortunate. Cat, stop rubbing your face on everything that exists. Some of that stuff isn't solidly, you know, affixed. Don't sass me. Goddamn cat. Hey! You watch your mouth. Roush is taking the cautious approach, which is a good idea since he is a tier 6, but he basically anything out there could hurt him. I don't think there's anything on the enemy team that couldn't immediately ruin his day. They're duking it out. I like how the Wolverine's way the hell back on the A1. Like, as useless as humanly possible. He will never see anything until it gets to, like, you know, C1. And then he's already dead. Please 2-4 getting out of the back area. And the cat agrees. Hello! Free shot. There is the Stuk. We have this. We have discovered the Stuk. Jawohl. And it's a good thing we have that KV-1 and the AT-2 and the T-67 all hiding in the back. They will be very useful. I'm not using enough sarcasm, really, but... You know, get over it. Come on, baby. Come on, baby. Yeah! There we go. Long distance. Long range pimping. Now we must reload. The reload time on this clip and the reload time on the T-49 is actually pretty similar. It's like an extra 3/4 of a second to get a clip into the T-49. Ooh, juicy, juicy. Thank you. Well timed. PZ4 in the back. Now, what the hell is a T-29 doing? And why do we have people shooting the hill? Do we literally have people in the back who... These guys have to be bots. Like, there's no way that they're actual people, you know, shooting at things. Because if you hadn't noticed, they're putting shots directly into the hill, and the enemy's on the other side of the hill. That's kind of a thing that a person would know, because they have eyes. Most of them have eyes and brains. We are spotted. We are auto-locking. It's an interesting technique. I don't know if you can auto-lock that kind of a snipery shot, but okay. My cat has discovered a plastic bag in the background. She doesn't play with a whole lot of things, so when she actually does show up and play with something, then I generally let her go, and you might hear some, you know, considerable amount of rustling in the background. Hey, look, the KV-1's moving out of the back. Just in time to get completely smashed by the T-29. That is all kinds of funny. And I notice that our T-29 is also hiding in the back. Yep, owned. Completely owned. Run away! Run away! So Roush has got roughly 3 times the amount of kills of anybody else on the planet. Oh no, there was a guy who had a couple kills and he's dead. So he's useless. You are only useful if you are acquiring kills and are still alive. And I wish there was... I wish you could just punish people on your own team by killing them. Because they're pretty much useless. That guy in the Wolverine is entirely useless. He's, just really... There's nothing else. There's no other word that really describes that kind of person. Outnumbered and outgunned. Well, yeah, he wouldn't be if our T-29 wasn't a huge, soggy vagina. Everybody knows that the huge, soggy vaginas are not desirable. You want the smaller soggy vaginas. Those are much, much better. Thank you for calling. That's 4 kills. It's at this point that I think that perhaps Roush has to kill the entire enemy team. Because nobody else seems to be doing anything. And we will be raining hell down on him in... Yes, that will do... Oh, ninja, thank you. So he's 1 away from a Top Gun, and there's shit tons of targets left available. Now, if he just was going to get crafty after his reload's done, he could make a run down the 1-2 and see if he can flank and spank. The Nashorn, at least, has a brain, whereas our Wolverine... Apparently some timer has gone off in the butt that is the Wolverine. And, is decided that at just about 8 minutes, it's time to push off of the absolute rear end of everywhere. So that's helpful. I mean, I have seen games won by bots because the last guy on the enemy team was AFK. So, that's helpful. Seeing if the artillery is here. He is not, which means he's over in the other corner. Move. Who are you telling to move? You're the guy that was sat in the back the whole time, retard. I like that. That is, I'm going to take that as sarcasm from the party bus. Oh, look. The AT-2 sat in the same place the entire match and eventually got crushed by artillery. Wonder how that happened. Hello! Oh, it's a party. Are you kidding me? Are you doubly kidding me? You must be joking. We got 1 shell left. We need somebody to wound the artillery. Oh, not quite. Not quite. But that'll set us up nicely for the Top Gun. And we gotta be careful of the AT-7. I'm not really sure where he is. And everybody else is just sitting on the hill, except for the one tart ass that's sitting on the cap. That guy's got 92 hit points. That would be delightful. Oh, hello. Thank you. Oh, the AT-7 is the one on the cap. Okay. Me and my math. Yeah, the problem is that it takes a shitload of time for one person to cap out. Oh, look, the T-29's finally moving out of the back. He may actually have more than 300 damage to show for this entire game. I wouldn't put money on it. Actually, I'm really confused as to why that AT-7 is parked right where he is. Like, did he want to cap and start shooting at people? Because that is never a good combination. Dead booty. Dead booty, dead booty, dead booty, dead booty, dead booty. Oh, you evil bastards. That was going to be for Radley Walters, and I hate you. Thanks for coming out, though, you useless tard. Jesus. Okay, so we got to go find the KV-1. That is our only hope, and that is a dead tank. And they're deciding to cap. Yeah, that was not cool. Ooh, I finally shot something! I am useful! You fucking bastard. So, we got a full clip of gold. Got some gas in the tank. We're gonna go hunt down this fucker and put him in the ground. This guy is seriously either retarded or a giant troll. I don't know. He pushed your kill, lol. Yeah, it's not really all that funny, actually. Oh, lord, he's AFK. AFK, I'm gonna farm some damage. Hopefully that scumbag artillery can kill himself. Oh, that's what I like. Free, free, free. One more, yes! That's a Radley Walters as a tier 6 scout in a tier 7 game on a team that was determined to throw that fucking thing in the garbage. I more than applaud you, sir. That is how you stick it in the baddie's face and you rub their nose in it and you see what you did. Do you see what you did? Well, let's see what Roush did. Alright, so, ace tanker, kinda naturally. Arsonist, because the guy died by fire at the end. Radley Walters, high caliber, and Top Gun. I would say, oh, and Bruiser, because... Really, if you're putting that much fire down range, I'm assuming you're getting damage. I think it's 4 modules, or is it 5 modules? I just assume that that's gonna happen. Because he threw a lot of shit downrange. And almost 20,000 win 8 in a single game. That's pretty good, you know. Oh yeah, and he's got 4,400 XP. Almost 4,500 XP on a double. So, yeah. I know I've had games where it's times 3 weekends that don't end up that good. Mainly because I do some bullshit, but that's a whole other story. 2,509 damage with 8 kills, and actually our Easy 8 did pretty well for himself, and the T-29 looks like he fired more than a couple of shots. Awesome. And the only time that the SU did anything at all is to probably splash one guy very, very lightly and then steal that kill. Jesus Christ. What a douchebag. Mr. Monkey Plasm? You're a horrible person. That's all I have to say to you. You sicken me. Indeed. That unicorn actually put a whacking down on people. He was the best player on their team. Well done, sir. And we fired 35 shots, 26 hits, 26 penetrations. The aforementioned 2,500 damage. From 300 meters, he did 1,000. And he shot 10, killed 8. Actually, yeah, there was another one in there that got stolen from him. He could have had a pools medal in this game. That would have been awesome. However, teams being greedy whores, and, you know, I fall into that trap myself. But, whatever. Actually, there was, I believe you scroll back down through my, the videos way back, there was one with I did with Bocknack where, I set him up for a Radley Walters. The preface to that one was that I actually did, cock block him on like 2 games in a row. He could have had Top Gun and I killed the guy and like not paying the fuck attention. So yeah, it didn't go very well. Ammunition resupply on this was $76,000. So we kind of lost some money, but we got a lot of respect and we got a lot of shiny medals. So that all works out in the end. I'd say that's well and truly balanced. Enjoy your goddamn weekend.